Hello you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. First of all, excuse my voice in this video. I am still getting over being sick, but I have so many holiday videos and content I wanna get out for you guys. So I woke up today and I was like, if I'm not better, I'm still filming. So if you've been on my channel for a while, every single year I do a video on the highest paying reputable side hustles and part-time jobs, just because I know I have a big audience of single moms or college students or people who just wanna find something on the side. So I did this video last year and also for 2018, and those videos have just blown up. So I know that the YouTube and the Google search for how to make money at home is like crazy. So I was also doing a deep dive into my YouTube analytics, and something like 95% of people who watch these videos on my channel are not subscribed to me. You guys just found my video through a quick search. So if you are new, I just want to say I'm Jordan. I would love to have you subscribe here to my channel. I have an entire Boss Babe series where I do talk about reputable ways to make money from home. And then I do also make a full-time living on social media. So I have specific videos on how to make a living on Instagram and on YouTube, how to monetize those platforms, how to navigate the algorithm. You guys already know it's my absolute biggest blessing to work from home and be with my son full time. So I am just incredibly passionate about helping other women do the same thing. So for today's video, I have just once again, just done some research specifically just to benefit you guys on reputable companies where you can make a side hustle or like a part-time living. Obviously the more hours you work, you can take that income more into full time. So I'll obviously have every single website that I mentioned linked down below for your convenience. So be sure to check there. And then I do also have my personal Instagram and YouTube social media courses on a huge blowout sale for Christmas time. So if you are wanting to make a full-time income on social media, definitely check down there as well. I would love to have you guys in those. The first company I want to mention is called Fiverr. So on this, you actually make a profile explaining your talents or what area of expertise you can provide. Then people can go on the website and they can hire you at whatever rate you set for yourself, which is cool. So you set your own hours, you work from home, you work from your laptop, all you need is a Wi-Fi connection, and then you set your rate based upon your knowledge or your skill or whatever you think you're worth, which is really cool. So with Fiverr, they do send you a 1099 at the end of the year. You are technically like an independent contractor, which you are for most of these, which is pretty common. So obviously just be smart and save a portion of your income for your taxes that you're gonna owe back. But with this, it's really cool. So a lot of YouTubers actually use this. You can log on there, you can hire someone to do a voiceover for you, to transcribe your videos in different languages. A lot of YouTubers log on there and hire people to edit their photos. They'll better like the lighting, the contrast, the exposure, photo editing, video editing. Another one was people on there can make, do video animation. They can actually create a website for you. If you're a small business owner and you need like an entire professional website set up, but you don't know how to do that, you can log on there and put that as your desired category. And then people will come up who have expertise in web development, and you can pay them a set rate and then they can obviously do that for you. They also have video animation, writing, translation. If you need something translated into another language, people on there can create music or audio for someone's project or for their YouTube video. And what's really cool is once you hire someone, they will send you the work that they do for you, and you get to preview it and you get to approve it before the payout happens. So all the payments are secure. You're never like paying someone for a project before they send it to you and then you get the final result and you don't like it. So that's really cool. Fiverr has actually been around for a few years and they have millions of users. So next up, you know I gotta mention Rakuten in this video. I have talked about it probably hundreds of times on my channel because it is legit amazing. I've been using the service and the site myself for almost 5 years. They're previously known as Ebates, and I've just mentioned them in so many videos because for me, it has not only become something where I get 25, 50, 100 bucks here and there, this has legit become for me a part-time income stream that I can rely and that I can count on. Website is incredible. If you've never signed up, they are the largest online cashback website. So you'll go to their site, you'll sign up. I'll have a link down below actually where you will get some free cashback just for signing up. I believe it's a free 10 bucks that you get when you sign up with that link, but I'll have it down there. But basically you'll log onto their site, and what blows my mind to this day is that it's completely free to use. There's no monthly fee, there's no yearly fee. It's completely free, and you log on and every single time you make an online purchase, they give you cash back. It's actually perfect that I'm putting up this video during holiday season because they have a lot of days on there now where it's double or triple cash back, which rarely happens. So definitely like try to snag those deals when you can. But basically for me, someone who works at home, I like to order my groceries online. I like to order clothing and craft supplies for my son. So say I want to shop at Kohl's or American Eagle or Ulta, I will log on to Rakuten. I will click on the website that I want to shop at. It will direct you there. And just for using their site for when they direct you to where you want to shop at, you'll make your purchase and they will give you cash back. And it blows my mind that it's completely free service to use, but literally just for shopping through their site, you get cash back on every single purchase. What's really cool is not only do you earn cash back for purchases you were already going to make, so you don't have to spend any additional money that you were never going to spend. Like, you literally just log online, make your normal purchases at your normal stores like you already would, but now you're getting cash back again, which is at no cost to you, which is awesome. But on top of that, their referral program is one of the best I've ever encountered. That's how I've personally been able to make so much money in referral bonuses. So I'm telling you guys, click the link below. Once you sign up, it's gonna give you your own referral link in your account. Send that to all your friends and family. They do give you a referral bonus every time someone signs up. And again, it's totally free for that person to sign up. And then when your bonuses continue to add up, they also have like bonuses on top of bonuses, if that makes sense. Once you sign up so many people, they give you bonuses in cash. So literally have all your friends and family sign up. If you're like me and on Black Friday, you're gonna be in your bed, in your PJs with hot cocoa, doing all of your shopping online, use Rakuten first. It will just give you cash back on every single purchase that you're gonna make. Okay, so next I just wanna mention a few delivery services. We'll mash them all together here, but these are something I personally use. I'm a consumer, I'm a paid client of all of these, and they're just incredible. So we have DoorDash, Uber Eats, and Grubhub. I'll have all the links down below. You guys can sign up for whatever like fits your personal needs, but basically you will just accept whatever orders are within your location and within your radius. You do have to have a car for this, or carpool, or share a car with someone or whatever. I believe they do a background check before they hire you. So you do have to be at least 16 and just have a valid driver license, a good driving record. But basically you will just go to restaurants and pick up people's orders and deliver it right to their house. Perfect for someone like me who works from home, or maybe I'm really busy with my son and I can't get to the restaurant to pick up the food. It's just a nice convenience to have it delivered. So you will actually just drive around to different locations. It could be a full-on restaurant like BJ's, or it could just be like Starbucks drive-thru, whatever. You'll pick up the order and you'll deliver it to that person. I know you are paid hourly with this. I also did some research. I know with DoorDash you can make $18 to $30 an hour, which is crazy. I live in California, minimum wage is like 12 bucks. So to make 20 or 30 an hour is like amazing, especially as a part-time revenue stream. With this one as well, I know you are also categorized as independent contractor, so just save some money for taxes for the end of the year, but for the time being, to like earn revenue very quickly, I know that's great, especially if you're a student or you're busy during the week and you can only maybe drive on the weekends. Those are the three that I have found that are the most reputable, where you can make the most money delivering food. All right, next up, I do just wanna mention Upwork, because it's something I've personally used in my business. This is how I found my VA. You can basically go on there to hire a graphic designer, a virtual assistant. So Upwork is a little bit more geared towards business and not necessarily YouTubing, as to where Fiverr, you can hire someone to do a voiceover or edit your videos. On Upwork, it's more like virtual assistant slash graphic designer slash web development work. I actually found a VA on there. A lot of people you can actually hire out of the country as well, so the pay is a little bit less. You do get to set your own rate, which is really cool. Based upon how much experience you have, you'll make your own portfolio and you can kind of put like your own resume and your picture on there, kind of like a LinkedIn profile, but you are able to do web design for people. You could set up like their Big Cartel or their Shopify or their like Wix website. It's also really good for small businesses. If you have a passion and a product and you want to grow your business, but you don't know how to necessarily run social media or run your website, you could go on Upwork and you could hire someone for a one-time fee. You don't have to put anyone on salary. You basically just pay people per project, which is really, really nice. That one as well is technically an independent contractor position, which most of these are, because they're not like year-round salary jobs. Which kind of leads me into my next one. You could manage social media for small businesses. This is actually something I dove into last year. The dentist, funny story, the dentist where I actually went to get my veneers done, I was a paying client. It wasn't sponsored or anything. I ended up really, really getting along with my dentist's wife. And they basically wanted to grow their dentistry. They were a little bit smaller, so they hired me on for a 3-month period to help grow their social media. So if you're younger, or you're in your teenage years, or you're in your 20s, and you're super savvy on social media, and you know how to navigate Instagram and Twitter and Facebook and navigate the algorithm and do location tagging, you could help a small business grow so, so, so much. I know a lot of people, like I said, who have a great business or a great idea, or they're really passionate about their product, but they don't know how to reach a new audience, or they don't know how to reach their ideal client. So what you could do, what I'd recommend, is going on Canva or going on PicMonkey and making yourself a little media kit, talking about or kind of explaining your expertise and your knowledge with social media. And then you could charge a company a flat fee to run their social media or run their Instagram or run their Facebook page to attract new ideal clients. You can maybe charge them for like, you could do a 60-day like test run. You could charge them whatever set rate you feel comfortable for 2 months. Maybe they want to hire you for 3 months or for 6 months. I know this is incredibly, incredibly powerful and informative, and it's a really good business investment for small businesses, again, who have an incredible product that they want to get out to the masses, but maybe they don't know how to navigate social media. That would be incredible. Okay, also, I do just want to mention really quick, I don't know if these are like no-brainers, because I know these ones have been around a while, but I recently found a new sitter for Sadie on Rover, which is just a phone app. So the consumer side of Rover is really cool, and like the business side, you could log in there if you need a sitter for your pet, or you need someone to come over and stay the night with them, or you need to have your pet walk, like your dog walked while you're at work, or you can sign up on the side where you actually work with the app and like you go over and walk people's dogs. You could give people's dogs medication. You could come over and give their dog a bath. You could set your own rate basically to like walk their pet or to stay and sit them for the day, or you could sit them for the night. I actually found an incredible, incredible dog sitter through Rover, and I've been using her now maybe like 7 or 8 months. I trust her completely. She has tons of experience with other dogs and giving medication and walks and taking Sadie to the park. She is incredible. She's brought so much joy to our life. It really helps me when I'm working all day and I say I have a busy day and I just can't take Sadie to the park. I believe I pay her, what is it, $25 maybe for the day. And then if I need her to come over and I'm on a vacation and she stays over and like watches my house, she'll watch the house and she'll watch Sadie for the entire night for like $35. Like, it's incredible. So in addition to that, but not on the pet side, if you need your little human watched and you need a babysitter, I have personally used Care.com in the past and I've used Sitter City. You guys have heard me talk about both. You could easily sign up on there if you have experience watching children. You can set your own rate per hour. And let me tell you, some of these rates are intense. My previous nanny, Miss Shauna, literally incredible, best nanny I've ever had. I trusted her with Christian so much. She had so much education experience. She's just amazing. I found her on there originally. She was incredible, but people charge a crazy amount for to watch your child, which I totally get. That's your baby, that's your pride and joy in life. You know, that should be something that is a higher expense because that's your child's safety. But when I've been browsing on there for new nannies since Miss Shauna actually moved, I have to hire someone new. I've kind of been browsing through people. I mean, people's rates for babysitting can range from 10 or 12 an hour, all the way literally, there's someone on there charging like 40 an hour. Like, it really depends how much experience you have with children. It also depends if you want them to be able to drive your child or take them to the park or do their homework. You can make a profile on exactly the talents or the knowledge and expertise that you have watching children in the past. If you're able to give medication, if you have a driver license, you can take the child somewhere. You could completely set your own rate for that. It's totally part-time. You could just do it on the weekends if you have another job during the week. And those sites are both extremely reputable. Okay, I feel like I've been talking forever now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Those are just a few ideas for you for the best side hustles for 2020. I hope you guys enjoyed. I would love to have you subscribe here to my channel. If you were new, thank you so much for just popping on, watching, spending a portion of your day with me. I really, really appreciate it. I'm also incredibly active on my Instagram. If you guys want to follow me over there, I'm doing 5 holiday giveaways, and I would love to have you anytime that I am not on YouTube. I'm always on Instagram story. It's so fun for me to connect with you guys over there. So I'd be so appreciative to also have you over there. You can also feel free to leave any video requests down below in the comments. I'm always looking through those and replying to you guys. And yeah, I hope you guys have an amazing rest of the week. Thank you for watching, and I'm gonna see you in my next video.
I saw you from across the room. When our eyes met, I never knew that I could feel this way.
In this video, I'm sharing the 7 best side hustles that you can start right now with little to no money or special training. Each idea you can get started with as quickly as today and start making money ASAP. Plus, what I really love about this list is none of these will require you to compromise your day job or give up all of your free time. And no, I'm not about to tell you to do a 1-hour survey to make 40 cents.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
And if anyone told you to do that, unfollow them because they're giving terrible advice, and follow me. This is Millennial Money in Business. We share the tools to help you escape your 9-to-5 with confidence every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So please do me a favor, hit like and subscribe. It tells the algorithm to show our video to more people, and it gets us that much closer to hitting our goal of becoming the first woman-led business channel with more than 1 million subscribers. I love a good side hustle. In fact, I start most of my businesses as side hustles, which gives me the opportunity to keep holding onto my main source of income when I experiment with this new side business. Find out what works and scale it up. And that is what I recommend you do. While we are sharing tips to help you escape your 9-to-5 with confidence, we would never, ever ever in a million years tell you to quit your day job without you having a solid secondary source of income to sustain yourself and the people that depend on you. That would be totally irresponsible. So instead, we're starting here with a side hustle. And special shout out to Lena Lore for inspiring this video. 2020 side hustle number one, virtual assistant. This has made the biggest difference in every single one of my businesses. Having an assistant to help with the tedious and repetitive tasks that come with running a business, like Silvio.
I like to rub her feet, wash the dishes, and walk around shirtless.
Yes, he does. Except virtual assistants work from home. You give them tasks you need completed and they do them. It really is that simple. And because I know how valuable they are for any startup or full-fledged business, I know there is a huge demand for talented and dedicated virtual assistants. I'm a fan of using Upwork. You can list yourself on the site for $15+ per hour. There are some people charging $50+ an hour, and you don't need a special degree or any special training to get approved. Number two, social media manager. If you have decent experience with social media, and of course you do, it is 2020, you can offer up your services as a social media manager. Now, I know you hear the title and think that you need some sort of special training, but trust me, you don't. We've hired several people to help with our social media that didn't have any special training, but they did show an understanding of each platform and a willingness to learn and grow. And that was it. What these companies are looking for is typically someone that can understand the message they're trying to convey with their brand, source images that complement that message, write out captions, include strategic hashtags, and schedule posts. That's the task at the most basic level, and while it is something a business or solopreneur can do themselves, that's 4 to 10 hours plus each week, depending on how often you're posting, that you'd be giving them back so that they can focus on growing the actual business. Now, if you'd like me to do a video where I go really high level in regards to social media, marketing, and strategy, I'd be more than happy to do it. Just hop down in the comment section and drop a dollar sign or money bag. Enough, and I'll make it rain, okay? Number three is easily one of my favorites. The third best side hustle for 2020, create a course. Thinkific, Udemy, and I'm sure there are literally dozens of other sites like these, but each of these sites allows you to relatively easily create a course on any subject and get paid from it. I have two courses up on Thinkific. One is a green business masterclass for $2,000 a pop, and the other is a hair business masterclass for $9.97. Both are linked down in the description. Because I took the time to put what was in my head from my own experience into a course, I make thousands of dollars in actual true passive income. Meaning I don't even mention them in videos. I just include a link in the description, and when people purchase, I get a notification that I just got paid. Friday night in fans. Party hopping, feeling right. Getting a little carried away with it. So yeah, of course, you can make it on any topic you feel like you know, and then all you gotta do is market it to the people willing to pay for it. Love that one. Very few passive income things are actually passive income. That is passive income. Number four side hustle for 2020, sell services on Fiverr and Upwork. We've already talked about virtual assistants. Well, Upwork is actually a marketplace where you can sell any service, not just the assistant stuff, whether it's graphic design, search engine optimization, international product sourcing, literally any and every kind of service is listed there. And on Fiverr, you can list any service you'd like to offer there too. And if you're thinking you don't have a skill, just look at the number of times this person has been paid to stand in front of a camera and read testimonials. Can you stand in front of a camera and read? Yes, you can. Can you do a good deed and take a pic of it? You can do that. Can you wear a bunch of keychains and talk like Captain Jack Sparrow? Well, then you got to side hustle. I don't even know what he's saying. Well, then you got a side hustle there. Hi. That's not him. That I'm sure is not how Jack Sparrow talks, but all these people are getting paid to do all of that stuff, as you can see on your screen. Number five is something I've told you time and time again is something everyone should do. It's a great way to market yourself as a brand or any business or service that you want to offer, and you can get paid from the platform for doing it. Anyone know what that is? YouTube! On YouTube, creators get paid from AdSense, which may not be much to begin with, but I'd still rather get paid a little bit of money versus none at all for me to market my business. It's usually just money going out. This is money coming back your way. Then the bigger your channel or platform grows, the more it pays you and you get more opportunities to collaborate with brands that want access to the people that consume your content. And if you have an audience, you can always create a product down the line and sell it to them. I love how Minority Mindset broke it down in this video. And you can find the link below to watch the whole thing.
Let's say you have 10,000 people who watch your videos, and out of these 10,000 people, just 100 of them buy a $10 product. That is $1,000 worth of revenue from just one video to an audience of 10,000 people.
Number six, sell hair extensions with white label extensions as your drop shipping partner. Shameless plug, yes. Do I need it though? Oh yeah. Six is technically start a drop shipping store, so if you're not really into the hair stuff, then but if you are considering it. So why not use the business I created for new entrepreneurs as the perfect example? If you aren't familiar, dropshipping is a business model where you just basically act as the middleman between a product manufacturer or distributor, like white label extensions, and the customer, and your only job is marketing. The thing that makes this a super dope option is the fact that you don't have to stock up on any inventory, you don't have to deal with the manufacturing process, you literally just pick a product that someone is willing to dropship for you. You market and advertise the product, and when you get a sale, you contact your dropshipper and they ship it directly to your customer for you. If the process is working right, you don't even physically touch or see the product. It all happens seamlessly. This is literally one of my favorite business models, as long as you have the order fulfillment process automated, which is way easier than it sounds. This model is totally scalable. Love that! Number seven, print on demand. This is similar to dropshipping in that you don't have to hold any inventory or handle fulfillment. All you do is design an item on a website like Teespring or Printful, market it, and cash in when it sells. This can be especially profitable if you can make merch that speaks to a specific and underserved niche. Now, some honorary mentions, because I don't want to drag this out, and I'm sure you guys don't need me to explain everything, but here we go. Rideshare. Got a car and a decent driving record? I don't. The driving record. And I hate driving. But if you don't mind, you definitely sign up. I mean, I think I met one of my last Uber drivers that was like, yeah, whenever I'm leaving work, I just turn on the Uber thingy and I get paid to drive myself home. That is really, really smart. You could do the same. Another one, flipping stuff. Buying stuff for the low and selling it for more online or wherever. Airbnb, got extra space, got an empty hallway, that could be a check. And you can tutor someone on a topic that you know. And last but certainly not least, get a part-time, regular job that you can work outside of your hours. Because if you're willing to work those extra hours and then pour money into your side hustle, that will fast track your growth. Of course, growing this channel to 1 million subs is our only goal this year. Why? Because representation matters, and there are a million guys with a million followers that talk about business, and there isn't a single channel where women talk about business that has more than a million subs. Not a single one. Not making that up. So, I've said it before, plan on saying it until we hit the goal, so go ahead and subscribe if you're tired of hearing this. But it's important that these little girls that only watch YouTube, which is like all little girls, see themselves represented in these bossy positions so they can know that that's like a real reality for them. You know that. So subscribe, help us get to that goal. And in the next video, I'm gonna share the top 3 marketing strategies for small businesses in 2020 that no one else is sharing. Each of these will help you increase your brand awareness, increase sales, and increase your bottom line.